What is going on, and welcome back to my channel. I am so happy to have you here. Make sure to subscribe down below for more videos, and let's just get into today's video. What we're gonna do today is talk about our bucket list. Not ours, mine. I had this idea because after Liam is getting so big so fast, I feel like days just go like this. So what I wanted to do is make a bucket list of ours for the rest of the year, all the way through December of this year, of 10 things that we want to get done. So what I've done is come up with a list of 10 things that I know that we want to do by the end of the year, and things that are pretty realistic. I think there's only one thing that makes me a little nervous, and of course there's so much more things that we want to do throughout the year, and we want to go to all these places, but I've really narrowed it down into kind of things that we can just kind of knock off the list on the weekends or take like a little drive. All that to say, let's get into my bucket list and the top 10 things that I want to do before the year is done. I want to make this, and then I'm going to vlog every time I complete something off of my bucket list. The first one is, there's this island called Catalina Island that's right off of California. It's so easy to get to. You get there for free on your birthdays if you're in California. And it's such a cool place. The first year that I came here, I went there for free on my birthday and I loved it. But the first thing that I do want to do there is I want to go snorkeling on Catalina Island. It's beautiful. So that's number one, and I want to knock that off this summer for sure. And I want to do that with Liam because he's such a water baby. So number two and three are actually in Seattle because we have a trip coming in Seattle with a group of friends. One thing that I want to do is the Amazon Spheres, which I know we have to schedule ahead of time. And the second one, I don't know if I'm going to say it right, the Chihuly Garden and Glass. Okay, so number four would be to go and take a long road trip down to the Big Sur. I want to drive along the Big Sur coastline, and I want to go to the aquarium. What's it called? A Monterey Aquarium, because apparently that's like a super, super nice one. I know I would love it. I know Liam would love it, and I want to do that with our dogs. Like, I want it to be a whole family affair, and all of us drive down there in our Tesla, and I know it's gonna be such a good time. We haven't taken a road trip in a while. I used to do it with Liam all the time, but he would just like sleep the whole ride. But now I feel like it'd be a little more uncomfortable for him. So we'll see how that goes. I mean, I know that's also something that we want to do before summer ends, but it doesn't have to be. So I know it's a gorgeous place too. Okay, so number five. Number five is very meaningful for me. And maybe not so much Joseph because he's never even been there. There is this winery. I'm not going to give the name because I want it to be my wedding vow renewal. Is that what it's called? I want to do like a wedding renewal of our vows. Oh my god, I don't even know how to say it right. But I want to do that with Joseph for like possibly our 10-year anniversary, which is coming up in a few years. And I went one time when my grandmother was out here, and when I got there, it was so, so, so beautiful. It was like Italy in California. Like, maybe I'm exaggerating just a little bit, but it was so gorgeous. The time we were there, there was weddings going on, and the scenery was just gorgeous. But what took it off the top was the hotel. I never actually stayed there. I just like walked around, but that's one. That's on my bucket list. Like, I want to go there with Joseph and Liam, and I want to stay at the hotel so we can check it out and see if it's like really gonna be like the winner or not. So that's on my bucket list to do, and just try to get Joseph down there and fall in love with the place like I did. And if not, possibly look for the next the next location. That would be really, really cool for me. Okay, number six is gonna be whale watching. I feel like there's so many, like, there's so many beautiful locations to do it, but I feel like if they have any in Malibu, that would be my, like, my number one place to go, because every single time I go, there is dolphins swimming out of the water all the time. It's so gorgeous. It's so beautiful to see. Like, you literally can see it from the beach. So imagine we take a boat out there. I don't know what it is about the location, but I always see them there. So I feel like that would be the perfect place, but I want to see a whale. Like, I want to see it so bad. I want to see how grand and huge they are. I've always seen them on the camera, so that's number six. Okay, the next one is a big one, which I'm not. It's definitely not for the summertime. I mean, it's definitely not going to be done by the summertime. But where we want to go, I know the main goal is to take a vacation out of the country with Leah or with that. We haven't made up our minds yet. But the location is between three different places. It's either going to be Bali, it's going to be Italy, or it's going to be Greece. Now take a guess as to which one is my option and then which one is Joseph's option. But yeah, we really, really, really want to go. The only thing that's so hard that I urge you guys to think about before you guys get pets, if you want to travel, is going to be so hard. And most of the time now, that's what's stopping us from traveling, because it's so hard and it's so expensive. It's like $2,000 for 2 weeks. Or a week and a half that we went for Liam's Hawaii trip. And so that's like a whole nother weekend trip that we could spend somewhere else. So I don't know, just the thought of spending that much money on just having the dogs watch kind of stop us from doing so. But that's a big trip and we really, really, really want to make it happen. So fingers crossed, manifesting all the good vibes by putting this video out there. So we'll see how that goes. Okay, so number eight is like oddly specific. It's eating at a restaurant called the Fairy Tale Restaurant. Actually, I don't know that that's the name of the restaurant, but I'm gonna put a picture here. It's a restaurant in Santa Barbara that obviously comes right out of a fairy tale. It's so cute. I just found it recently and we've been to Santa Barbara once. And I've been to Santa Barbara once and it's such a beautiful location. And the restaurant's like in the middle of nowhere. So I don't know, I just feel like that'd be something exciting. Like a little mini road trip, because it's like 2 hours from us. So I would definitely love to make that happen. Oh, okay. This next one is another restaurant that we want to eat at. And it's one that my girlfriend actually sent me that has the option for like all you can eat lobster. And now that you know me, you have to know my favorite food is like seafood. Probably wouldn't do the unlimited lobster just because the price is crazy. And like, I feel like you would get over it after like the first or second plate. But the food that they have at this restaurant looks so good. Such good food options of like all different types of seafood things. Oh my gosh, I thought my dog was in here. It was touching my leg, but it was just my sweater. Almost had a heart attack. But yeah, so that's two restaurants that I definitely want to like knock out of the bucket list. The last one, not a major one, I probably should have left like the out of country trip for the last one. This one is just inspired because I watched Stranger Things recently. And the whole like roller skating vibes, ice skating vibes have given me the urge to want to do that. So I'm thinking it can actually be something like if we choose to do the ice skating, we can wait for winter for that. And so, you know, that's something we could push out to the end of the year. But I've always, my birthday's in February and I'm originally from New York. I lived there growing up. So most of my birthdays I feel like were spent going ice skating. So I'm pretty good, I'm pretty talented. Maybe, maybe it's been so long that I forgot everything. But I don't know, I just want to try that again. I wanna see if I still have my skills. Okay, so what I have is a challenge for you. I want you to make a list of 10 things that you wanna do before the end of the year. And you don't have to share it with me, but let's knock them off. Let's make the end of the year, the rest of the year, count. Like, let's just make these amazing memories. We were locked up, we can be outside, like we're free now. But yeah, let's just enjoy our life, make some memories, and be kind along the way. So I hope you guys subscribe, give this video a thumbs up if you did enjoy, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.